What's up, everyone? My name is Zexnor Prodigy X, and welcome to another Legend of Korra video. I'm kind of mad right now, mainly because, well, I had to redo the game all over again, or not redo the whole game, but I had to get back to the part I was originally at, because, I came back, I was on my Mac, and, well, nobody knows. I found out that my brother was playing this game, and I checked to see if my save files were, you know, all good, and turns out they weren't. They were all jacked up, so he basically restarted the game, and I had to redo the game. So that may be why you see a few differences here. Well, not many noticeable ones, but mainly the level of my waterbending. It was at level 4 last time we left it off. And now it's back at level 3, so yeah. Alright. But I do have my layout pretty much the same, so I think that's all good, so yeah. Alright, so we are in Republic City, and this is probably one of the more longer chapters in this game. I can very well say that this may well be the longest. Maybe, maybe not. I don't know. We'll just have to wait and find out. Alright. So there are a whole lot of, like, chi blockers who have, like, the little shock things and, you know, those right there. So, yeah, I forget exactly what they're called. There was a name they used for them, but I forget. If you guys could remind me in the comment section for future episodes, that would be perfect. So, alright. Oh yeah, and now we can finally, you know, break one of these to get, like, a chest or something. Alright, so let's do this. You have to break these fast. I should probably use my airbending combo there, because my airbending combo is the fastest combo I have. So, it probably would have been smart to do that. Alright, so we're about to get cornered. Oh, motorcycle guys. I freaking hate those guys. Holy crap. Alright, but I do have my range stuff here, so I can do a little bit of damage on them before, you know, the motorcycles break fully. Alright, and I can dodge because I can use my little invincibility frame that dodge gives me. Alright, there we go. And how did I miss that? What the heck? How do you miss finishing moves? I don't understand that, to be perfectly honest. Alright. Why are you attacking me? So I need to do a little bit more dodging. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Nope, you ain't getting me there. And also, by the way, when I was watching back while editing one of the episodes, last episode more specifically, every time I talk, Korra decides to talk. Like, shut up, Korra. Looks like chi blockers have taken over the abandoned part of the city. But anyways, I was checking back while I was editing the video, and I saw that you could I heard, actually, more specifically, that you guys could hear me tapping on my controller. Now, I don't know if you can hear it now, but because from what I noticed, it was mainly just that one episode. But, yeah, I'm hoping that isn't bothering you guys, because I have my mic setting on, because I have a Blue Snowball microphone, if you guys didn't know, and the Blue Snowball microphone has different setups, like different variations. Yeah, I forget. I'm having trouble figuring out words that go to. Yeah, I don't know. But anyways, though, the Blue Snowball has three different mic settings. That's what I was trying to say. Why was I having trouble saying that? But it has three different mic settings. The one I'm using is mic setting 1, which is more commonly used for gaming. And that is the one I'm using right now. Because mic number 2 is the one that I use for, like, my Kingdom Hearts videos, which is basically the podcast one. Which, I like. It is probably the best setting, the best sounding one anyways. So, yeah, I mean, I would use that one, but I don't really feel like, I don't really want to be all close up to my mic, because it's just weird to me. Alright, let's dodge all those, and I forgot to replenish My spirit water, I think that's what it is. The thing I just used to heal myself just a minute ago. Nope. So let's get our water bending back to level 4 so I can get this new combo. I probably could have grinded for it, but then I would have been over leveled from last episode, and we don't really, well, I kind of want to do as much as I can on here. Okay, wait, okay, it's taking way too long to break that chest. See, airbending is quicker, way quicker, and I got a rank B on him. Alright, so, wow, we're only 5 minutes in, it feels way longer than that to me. Alright, and more motorcycle guys, I don't like you. Nope. That didn't do anything, okay. Alright, let's get rid of you, and even though I just missed there, get rid of you too. Alright. If I missed there, I would've went off. I would've went off on this game. I just would've went off on everything. Like, how? This, it doesn't make sense. How do you miss a finisher move? I've done that twice in this Let's Play, but I've barely ever done it in my Let's Plays, in my playthroughs by myself. So, yeah. Alright. I don't know why I was hitting there. So this is when waterbending becomes most handy. Like, moments like these, this is why I say waterbending is better for ranged attacks, because it is. And by the way, I know we saw these guys last episode, didn't we? And you fight these guys a lot, like a whole lot. So get used to it. Get used to it. Like I told you last episode, if I even said it, this game does not have a lot of variation when it comes to enemies. Alright. Nope, stop it. Alright, whoa, level 4. Alright, my health is fully recovered now. Alright, now I have a little bit more on my combos. Nope. Alright. Dang, I could have done that epic Dragon Ball Z thing there. But, you know, we can always do that another time. Oh, hello. Sorry if I was a bit quiet there, trying to focus on that. That part you can mess up on. I mean, it's not common that I mess up on it, but it's just kind of talking, like commentating while playing a game makes you a little bit worse at the game. I don't know what I'm trying to say there, but it just kind of depletes a lot of focus, which isn't a bad thing, because I mean, I'm playing through this game for guys' entertainment. Whoa. Like, let's say one of you So that line right there, that from what she said, that kind of confirmed that this whole game takes place after Chapter 2. So yeah, I mean, I believe that's when she fought Unalaq. Yeah, that is because, oh crap, I just hit my desk there. But yeah, it is, because I haven't watched all the seasons in a while. So yeah, I mean, you know, they were finished like quite a bit ago. Now, I don't know if it's just me, but like, that part right there reminds me of this one part from Jack and Dexter. I don't know, maybe it's just me, but it just reminds me of that one part from Jack and Dexter. Alright, if you play that game, of course, though, because like, if you haven't, then you don't even know what the heck I'm talking about. You probably can hear because I'm kind of listening to myself tap my controller right now. It's kind of is a little bit loud. I may have to fix that or just move my back up my microphone a little bit. But then my voice will be quieter though. Decision, decision. I don't think it's that loud personally, but you know, some people, I mean, some people have a bigger tolerance for things than others. So, yeah. Oops, stop it. Nope. Those guys, like, you can't dodge the little shock attacks, so that's why I keep Alright, well, yeah, I said you can't dodge it when I was about to say you can dodge. What I mean is, you can't, like, counter them. I'm having trouble saying words. That's really, I'm gonna have to fix that if I want to do future Let's Plays. But, you know, everybody know you grow over time. Like, right now, I'm a beginner YouTuber, so why was I just hitting the wall? Now, this part, you can easily die here. Like, I almost did there, so I'm gonna actually hit these guys from a distance. Which is why waterbending is alright. I don't know. I may grow to like waterbending more and more over this Let's Play, to be honest. Because it's pretty good now, but maybe I'm only saying that because it's the only bending I have. Once I get my other bendings, I might use those a little bit more. Alright. I didn't even see that spawn, so... Damn it! Alright, can I get that chest from there? Yes, I got it. Yes. Alright, rank C item, but still. Still good. Still good. Don't have to go back later for that chest. Nope. Go away. Yep, couldn't block that, could you? And now, motorcycle guys. For the third time this episode. I mean, well, we are in the city, so what do I expect? Well, at least I'm not missing today. Well, she just drove right into that. I wasn't even planning that right there. Alright. Okay, let me break that thing there, and, well, guys, that's the end of today's episode, because what's going to come up next, we do not have enough time for. How do I know? Because I've played this game before. So, yeah, anyways, next episode, there will be a boss battle, well, yeah, as much of a boss battle as this game can have, to be honest. But anyways, guys, this has been X1 Prodigy X. With Legend of Korra, and I will see you guys next episode in part 6, and I will see you guys next time.